Thank you so much for your time, and good luck with your efforts.
Thank you.
And I believe the CCN amendment is an upcoming project.
Yes.
For instance.
My name is James Johnson, and I have some property on Woodley Road. I tried to call Chris and Christopher in the city yesterday. Apparently, I don't have good numbers, so I've got 210-225-5454 from the city attorney.
It's 830.
Okay, this is 210 is the letter that you sent me, so. Appreciate you clarifying that.
It's 830-216, sorry, there's more. It's 830-216-4075. But to talk to the city attorney's office, you'll need to go through City Hall on there, and then they can schedule a meeting with the attorneys.
I called City Hall and I got no response, and I asked for a return call and I got no return call. So is there a good number at the city where we can call and get a hold of someone? Chris, I called and they said, you don't work there anymore, so where do you work? Okay, so now I can reach everybody. Just a quick comment, I'm not in favor of this. My cows don't need your help. And we will be taking advantage of the contract. But, so this one's really not good.
Correct, the cover sheet on there?
The original.
The draft contract is
check the standard.
Yeah, that's the standard agreement. That's the base that everybody will be working off of for negotiations.
Okay, but this is not what it indicates. I should sign and get it back to you. You don't.
No, and if you have anything to negotiate, then we'll have negotiations. If not, then there'll be a final one for signature when we have these meetings with everybody.
Okay, and you have your action of schedule meeting.
Yeah, but we'll schedule meetings. We'll have all the people that receive NDAs be called and have a meeting time.
Do you know what the timeline's going to be for the closing to the end? I know we have some word constituents that they're worried about the time frame. You can't say what's going to be this day and close the other day.
I don't know exact dates. I'm still trying to coordinate that with the city attorney and with your staff.
Okay, so because right now it seems like it's other people that were here, they're very worried about the time frame. They don't want to miss out on anything. So I think it would be safe to say that until further notice, don't worry about it.
We will contact each of those property owners that are eligible for the agreement, and we'll get a date for them to come in and finalize the negotiations based on that standard agreement.
So this August, they may not be ready to start that.
So that July timeframe that you're talking about is not valid?
The we're under a deadline with the statutory process to wrap things up by August 18th in terms of the negotiations. But we're also required to have the hearings during this time, so that's where we are in the process. We're going to be starting now that everybody's had a chance to look at the agreements and hear the public testimony. We're ready to start the negotiations. It's simply a question of finding.
Are we going to have any extensions to this? You know, where you could go above.
I'd have to look at the statute and see on there. We are stuck with time.
So you know the deadline is from August what, 18th?
The 18th is the hard deadline. We want to have everything in order by August 1st, so we're not public against that.
I want to go ahead and echo that. If there's any leeway in the statute to extend the deadline, I think we're wearing that kind of thin out. And it'd be good to, I know Mr. Waters suggested a November date. That might be a better date.
I'll look and see if you have
My name is Apache Atkinson. And I want to know when the city's going to put up the chain-link fence up by the recreational track, because they took the city put down the fences, and now the cattle can't be in their ground fence. Do you know when they're going to do it? Does anybody know?
Excuse me? Did you say this, our city employees knocked down your fence?
Well, it couldn't have been the railroad employees. Somebody knocked it down.
You need to look at that, Mark.
I have looked at that, and he's referring to when we had criminal pedos for FEDC, so that predates me, and they can't find any documents or any records of that, because FEDC took care of that. Criminal pedos was the one who made the agreement when they put in the bridge, both the red one and the black one. It was not a city project.
No, I understand that, but if our city employees, whoever, whether it was FEDC or the city employees, knocked down the fence, we're liable for it. Is that correct?
That fence was not down when we were building the trestle. That's the same for recreational.
I didn't know.
Track.
Those trestles were purchased by FEDC, relocated to the city. They received some grant, but it had to be over 20 years ago, so I would not have.
But whether you were here or not here, we need to take care of the problem if the city has anything to do that.
They need to tell it, it's just not things.
Can we get this to FEDC as quickly as possible and find out where they stand on this?
Yeah, Henry, we'll get it over to Tommy Baker and see if they have any records or anything.
I've spoken to Mr. Baker about this. He has no regulation or any records at all. And because this property is actually in the county, it is not in the city limits, we can't put up things to do that. I cannot find any documentation from the city that we were supposed to do that. I've spoken to the associate that said he would find some documents that he said that happened 20 years ago. He may have some things that we can start looking at that. But I have no records of that at all.
But it's not on record, but they could knock it down. And that's what happened. They knocked the fence down, the old fence was there.
The bridge was put in sometime between 15 to 20 years ago, hiking by train. I don't have any documents or anything in reference to that. I have spoken to Mr. Baker on FEDC. I have no agreements. I can't find any.
Are you saying that this fence was knocked down 15 years ago?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Those trusses haven't been there that long.
Yes, sir.
It's
been there that
long. Yes. Like 20, 30 years?
How many feet is it? How many? West County property, right?
I know that.
How many feet
that
are you talking about?
I know that.
How many feet are you talking about?
But the city knocked it down.
How long a fence is it?
Well, it's 36 acres. That's a long fence. And now the cattle can't be in there because there's no fence. It was knocked down. Because they were going to build up a chain link fence 6 foot high along the recreational track. See, that track was for hiking, biking, and riding scooters or whatever. So they asked me.
If they knocked down your fence, it would have been a barbed wire fence. You didn't have a chain link fence.
The chain link fence, they knocked it down. No, they knocked down the fence. Well, what's the chain link fence they were going to put up?
Oh.
See?
That's a barbed wire fence.
Yeah, it was an old barbed wire fence.
Yeah.
But we knocked it down. We went in and we knocked it down. We're by the door.
That's right.
Whether it's county or state.
That's right.
Chris, do you have any suggestions on this?
We'll need to talk to FEDC because really the city should be spending taxpayer funds outside of the city limit. So we need to see if it was FEDC and if they have any records.
Well, Chris, if the city knocked down the fence, whether it's in the county, the state, or whatever, you're liable for it.
Yeah. Well, Henrietta's saying it was the FEDC that did it, so they'd be
the
liable.
FEDC belonged to the city of Floresville.
But how did they'd be responsible.
Be the statute of limitations.
Well, there wouldn't be. It's a 4 years if there was a contract that could be found. If not, it would have been 2 years.
Okay, what can we do if we can get in this guy? Went out there all the way on my home. I mean, signed the paper that I went along. So I signed the paper. These other neighbors of mine signed the paper. I'm not just saying it because I'm crazy. I'm telling it like it is. See? Now, you can't put no livestock in there. Why? There's no fence. They'll roam all over the world.
Is there any way of getting a copy of what you signed? You said, do you have a copy? Does
no, that Hispanic guy that was working there, man, their land.
Jesse Perez? Colonel Perez?
Yeah, that's what they tell me. I don't know his name.
My question is, how did they work in the county when city is not supposed to be in the county?
Well, he said it was a city.
Yeah, the FEDC has some other things that they're not necessarily bound by us because they don't operate solely off of.
So the FEDC had city employees do that?
No, I didn't have city employees. Yeah. He subcontracted out. It was a subcontractor. It was not city employees.
So can we find an original subcontractor?
That would be in the FEDC records if they have them.
Or Mr. Baker can't find any records.
He has not been able to find any records.
Just in terms of to keep two good records.
The stories I hear about that person, that he was robbing the city.
But you have to know. I will say to tie it into this, if that area is annexed, then that would be within the city, and the city could see about securing the hike and bike trail at that time.
Simple Simon could take care of it. Simple Simon. But see, Simple Simon, very easy, I'll tell you how. They put some blocks on each side of the trestle to keep vehicles or whatever, four-wheel drives or whatever, out of the trestle to block on both sides. And not only that, but where's the fence? They put the fence up, they knock those blocks out, and that's it. They took care of the problem.
Let me ask you, would you be in agreement for the annexation of your property?
No, I would not. Especially when the city says they're going to do something, and they forget about it. Oh, we don't know nothing. We can't find David. We can't do that. What the hell is wrong? People wake up. See? I'm blind, and I'm awake. Wake up! Take care of it, so simple. Knock down those stupid blocks that they put on each side of the trestle. That's one. That's not difficult. You want King Kong to go out there and do it? King Kong is not the city. Anyway, the chain link fence, that's what I, with the gates, to get the tractors going from one side to the other. It's not that difficult to do. It doesn't cost that much. Oh yeah, they built a trestle for $1,000, but they can't do something that's so simple and that don't cost that much. And besides, the city's fault because they're the one that screwed up, the city. If you don't screw up, you're okay. But lately, I've been noticing, not just the city, the banks, they screw up because they hire Simple Simon off the streets. And Simple Simon is Simple Simon. He doesn't know. We gotta wake up.
Mayor, I'd recommend asking, getting with Mr. Baker and seeing if he can send somebody out to look at it or something.
So simple.
We'll go from there.
Okay. Yes, we'll make that recommendation.
Good evening. My name is Larry Wolney. I also have property next to Mr. Appaloosa, and I got a quick question. Maybe I should have done some research. The Camino Real hike and bike trail that was put in went all the way to the golf course. My understanding was in the past there was supposed to be a city park put in the golf course back in that area along the river, and something happened to the property and no longer enough property to put the park in there. But the hike and bike trail was open all the way to the golf course and dead ends. Is that Camino Real part of the city or just part of the county? Because I know it goes all the way through the city of Florida. Who maintains that hike and bike trail?
The city of Floydville has its ownership approximately 3 miles of hike and bike trail. It goes from 97, which is right out here, all the way through to the golf course. Beyond the golf course, it actually belongs to the developer, Mr. Richardson, his development. When it goes beyond that last bridge, that is belonged to the Riverbend Association. But from that bridge all the way to 97 is city property, approximately 3 miles.
Okay, so the city has taken responsibility. My understanding was it belonged to the railroad, and the railroad wouldn't sell it. It was supposed to be leased so they could come back and do whatever they needed in the future.
The above is the railroad.
The railroad has given the city an easement agreement. They allow us to use it for hike and bike, but it does not, we do not have ownership of it. We just have the rights to it. It's still owned by the railroad, but the city does maintain it.
And if they decide to put a railroad in, again, they can't.
Exactly. That was my understanding as well, because in the past, the county commissioner, I can't remember his name, closed that off right there at the city limits sign. And we use that whole area for cattle grazing. Since the city came in and opened that back up, we have no longer been able to use it for grazing because, like she just said, it's maintained and it's part of city property, but the city's not wanting to put any fences up there to keep individuals off my property or allow me to use it for grazing for cattle because now it's all open. And to me, it goes to the golf course and ends, and there's no place for anybody to go except turn around and come back. I've had several instances where people have come in from the golf course and from the city and trespass on my property, and Mr. Appaloosa's. I've had hunters down there hunting, and it makes a very dangerous situation. I've posted no trespassing signs, and I have pictures of people who were down there illegally who shouldn't have been there. And it's not just trespassers. There's a lot of criminal elements. We were talking about how many times people need to call the police. My issue is that since I'm still in the county, the city doesn't want to respond to it because I'm in the county, but yet at the same time, the county says I'm within the city, ETJ. So we're juggling back and forth who's going to come out and respond. So yes, naturally, I have to protect my property with Smith & Wesson, like everybody else, because I don't know who's going to respond. And I've had trespassers where I've had to call the police and file trespassing charges on certain individuals, and the county had to come out and take care of it. But at the same time, if the city owns that property, why can't the city maintain that property, put the fences up? Because there's times here in the last few months that I've gone up and down checking my property from that Black Bridge back to the golf course and even back.
Is your place fenced in?
Beg your pardon?
Is your place fenced in?
No. Part of it is and part of it isn't. But I had to put the fences up myself because the city didn't want to cooperate. Because that's the hurdles that I spoke about in the last meeting that we had.
Well, no, normally how it goes, you know, whoever owns one side of the property and you own the other side, you meet in the middle, 50%.
The railroad track is in the middle. The railroad.
I know, but.
So you're saying put my fence up in the middle of the hiking back trail?
Well, that's something that you would have to maybe look at with Ed Baker and see what type of agreements, because you need to close off your area. You know.
Well, I would like to close off. The county commissioner eventually closed it off, and at one point the city decided to open it.
Well, since you're in the county, you should bring that up to the county commissioners whenever they have their meeting and ask if they would go 50% with you building your fence.
Okay.
On both sides of them.
Is the county commissioner going to come back and tell me the same thing you're telling me since the city owns that property, take it up with the city?
Well,
or is there a way that we can close that hike and bike trail right there at the city limits that are currently open right now? Because right now, I've had criminal elements, I've had stuff stolen from me when I'm not there.
No, nobody's saying anything about that. I'm just trying to where you could get your fence put up. I don't know if we need to see what type of agreements we have with the FEDC from the railroad, see if you could put your fence. I'm sure you could put it, but you can't put it on the hike and bike trail.
Do you own both sides of the hike and bike trail?
I do. All the way
and how many feet you got on?
From my understanding, the railroad had supposedly 50 feet on each side of the railroad.
Okay, how many feet along the railroad track do you own that needs to be fenced?
Let's just say I go from the current city limits sign right now all the way to the golf course.
1,500,
1,600 feet. I'd have to look it up on the map. But the thing is, I know in the city has placed fences up all along the hike and bike trail to keep people off private property. But since the city owns that hike and bike trail where it is out there, they haven't done anything.
Where the cattle were, yeah, there's nothing. But in the city, there was
Even a cattle guard or something would have been sufficient to help us out to keep them from going into the city. But I've lost how many years of grazing and money that I've lost over years because the city, who we thought we were going to work well with, hasn't been like you. Go talk to the county. Talk to the county, they tell me to go talk to the city.
Excuse me, sir, this is the first time I've heard you mention this, so.
Well, that's true. How long have you been?
I'm trying to put my.
No, that's just fine, Mr. Mendez. I appreciate it.
Trying to get you some help. But I think it would be good to go and talk to the FEDC, to Ed Baker, and maybe the committee, bring it up when they're having their meetings and see what, and to the commissioners board and to come back to the city and see if we could all work together to try to get something established in y'all's area so that way you can get something resolved.
This is just some of the hurdles that I've been talking about trying to get over, because I don't mind working with the city, but at the same time, I just feel like it's only like, this annexation, are we going to have a vote on it, or is it something the city's going to decide on their own? They're just listening to it because it's part of the process that we have to go through for legal purposes, and then y'all are going to make up your minds regardless of what everybody's saying?
Can we organize a meeting between the county, FEDC, and the homeowners that are being involved with it? At least have an initial meeting and see if there's anything we can do?
I can see what's up meeting, and I'll go back and look at our records to see if FEDC has anything. I just want to remind that at first, even some of our parks, FEDC had control of them, and they transferred to us. Initially, FEDC tried to sell the field warehouse, but they could not because of the lease that actually belongs to the city, the railroad. So we'll see what's up meeting to discuss this.
It's real simple. Is your property on the county? Or is it in the city?
We're right on the edge of the city when it's signed.
So part of it's county?
It's all county.
It's all county? Well, it's a county issue. It's not a city issue.
Yeah, but the annex, that's where he's talking about.
Oh, you're saying after it's annexed?
After it's annexed.
After it's annexed, because we haven't gotten anywhere because the county tells me the city has ETJ.
I understand that, but you should be able to put your fence up if you're in the county, go to the commissioner's court and see what they've got. Right now you're in the city.
Yes, I do feel that at least setting up a meeting will get the ball rolling and getting some talks.
Yes.
I'm not saying that that's going to be the answer, but at least it's a start.
Well, at least we're moving forward. It's better than with the responses I've had so far, because like Ms. Turner, I know my father's trying to contact, and I know you guys were busy. I'm not making excuses, but we tried several times to get a hold of city manager. We tried to get a hold of city officials.
We've been several times by the Highway Bike Trail. But the issues that the ballots that you spoke of are there. The city, I did not put them up. They have been there for some time. I understand that there was a problem with people with ATVs that were riding up and down. And so both with the red and the black bridge and the black close to the golf course have ballots, but you can't go through. You can walk through and have lights go through, but you can't take that ATV or
ATV. Can we make sure that we have your contact information and we will get that meeting scheduled?
I'm sorry, but do you mind? If we don't have an existing contact with the Railroad Commission that's reliable, could we get one? Because I believe they're also a stakeholder in this that we might need to deal with.
I think it's a Union Pacific Railroad.
It's Union Pacific.
So I think we've got contact with them.
We have contact with their position because we applied for some issues with Hiking by Trail. Their position is that they've given the use of it to the city. We can't sell it, we can't divide it up. We have use of it for
a we only have use of it, so in the decision-making process of whether this fence can be built, they're going to be fine to say because that's their property.
If you know, built on his property, gambling property.
The property of the railroad that we're using right now belongs to the city.
Well, I
think that. Yeah, the thing that we have an easement that allows us to do pretty much anything we want with the surface, unless they decide that they want to reestablish the railroad, in which case they have priority.
If I may, like I mentioned, we've got the hiking bike trails for so many feet on each side. If y'all have the lease, y'all should have the lease from each side of the 50 feet right away on each side, correct?
It runs down the center line.
Okay, well that's what I'm saying. So there should be no issue or question about whether or not the city, since they have it, you know, you have
the lease will be right on the property line. There's no issue. This part's getting out of hand on that. There won't be no issue. The issue is we can't put a fence in because it's county. When it comes to annex, we should be able to help you out and put a fence in. But we got to get FEDC involved because they were the original players in it. And at that point, after we annex it, then we should be able to come to some type of agreement to be able to help you. What it is, I don't know. There's barbed wire fence, post, properties.
That's as long as it keeps trespassing on the property is my main concern, but I guess what I'm asking is the city can own county property?
No.
Because y'all just told me that y'all have a lease, that hike and bike trail is the city.
Yes.
It's not county anymore, that's city, because the city maintains it and has a hike and bike trail on it, correct? All the way to the golf course. That's part of the city, that is not county. Mr. Neeson, you keep telling me that's county property. It's not county property, it's the city only.
Your county property.
I'm county property.
Your county property.
You go right through the middle of my property.
Right, and so the fence will be on your property and the Gray Road property. So, once we have full city rights, we can do it.
And if I may, Mayor and City Council, as Chris alluded to before, we did our first annexation, phase one. The county has approached the city because there's this in and out and there's this gray area that the county has identified some of these areas that they would rather to be in the city limits rather than the county alone. And so this was one of the areas they identified that they would like to have included in our annexation, and we did take that under consideration when we did our initial planning.
Wait, you built the trestle. Very simple time ago.
We're calling waivers.
We do need to stick on the annexation.
We're calling an annexation.
Yes.
If I could, just because I want to, this is kind of its own separate issue. I think it needs its own attentions and it's kind of its own set of maps and research. I'd like to offer that if we do get a meeting set up with the county, I'd be happy to donate an afternoon of my time to work with the property owners, work with the city, work with the county, so we can figure out what the facts are and have a plan to move forward.
That plan was fenced before they went out there and built that trestle. They went to me all the way to the hill country, in woods. I live in the woods. Can't you see how I live? Like in the woods. And they wanted me to sign a piece of paper that I would give them the right to build a trestle. I would go along with it. See?
Okay.
I signed it, he signed it, his father signed it. And then the guy that got the paper that went looking for me all the way to the hill country didn't give us a copy or nothing. But he worked on the proposal. He worked at Dano, whatever his name is, Paris or something. Anyway. You signed a piece of paper that you'll go along with building that track, recreation of track for the city.
Yeah, and I think they're going to try to schedule a meeting so everybody can get together.
Well,
and try
they got to do it with them, not with me. I'm not going to come back no more. I don't have time to be pulling around. See? I may look like simple timing, that doesn't mean I'm simple timing.
We'll try to get something rolling as quickly.
You guys got to get it straightened out because that's against the law. To knock down somebody's fence, property fence, and get away with it. That's not right. That's worth the trespass. You can't keep livestock in there because there's nothing to keep them there.
Okay, well, thank you so much for being here.
All right.
Any other citizens' comments at the moment? All right, Scott, do you have any last words that we will be concluding our...
Chris,
I'm sorry. Chris, I'm sorry. Do you have any... We will be...
No, I don't have anything further to say. I'll continue to make myself available for comments or questions. As we go forward, I'll continue to work with your city attorney and your staff to handle negotiations and work through the rest of the process. Thank you.
I have a question. I don't know if I should ask or not, but I'm going to go ahead and ask. Mr. Appaloosa, why did you wait so long to tell us about the fence?
Again, here we go.
No, I just
want to know.
Okay, I just want to know why you.
Why?
Why did you? Did you ever report it to somebody?
I'm going to tell you.
Tell me, please.
So everybody can hear.
Okay.
Again, from last week. I can't be coming to Fort Sale whenever you guys want me to be. There's a reason why I can't come to Fort Sale.
I know, because
it's about my time to get ready to die. You think you're ready. You don't know about me. I can't drive. That's the reason why I can't be coming to Fort Sale. I let those people use my land for the cat, because I'm a good guy. Now, why can I come? Why can I die?
Why did you wait so long?
I'm telling you, child, I'm telling you. You're just not listening. Damn, Sam.
Thank you so much. We'll be getting you.
All right, get to it.